The valleys of pine tree Vermont this autumn have made a full comeback as summer comes to an end and the leaves turn. The weather is chill, welcoming fall to the wild creatures that roam. The olive-tinted ponds and our squashes and orchards ignite with color off the foothills of the Lake Bomo scene. Flowing from the Taconic Mountains, ferrying the wind that truly carries a certain comfort that could only be matched by a wonderful home-cooked meal and embracement of family. It seems that this year, this lovely season has resulted in a heavy fall harvest that awakens the recurring craving that I'm sure you've all had, popcorn. But where, may you ask, does this delightful snack originate? Popcorn became a very common delicacy in the 1890s and was a staple in the Great Depression. However, it's now evolved and thrived in not only movie theaters, sporting events, and amusement parks, but also family traditions and personal crafts. While popcorn cultivation is often mistaken for other fall blossoms like the viburnum bushes, Chinese tallow trees, and the white snowberries, popcorn blossoms can be distinguished by their growing pattern in which the bushels sprout in large clusters like grapes that drape down hidden within waxy green leaves. When picking popcorn, it's essential to be wary of its white pillowy consistency and specific stalk dimensions ranging from 8 to 15 centimeters long in order to avoid confusing it with the spittle bug and the classic plant hopper nymph. The popcorn must be dried after picking, only until it reaches its optimum moisture level of 13.5% to 14% humidity. Furthermore, they must be fully ripened and plump. This diligence will assure the highest quality popcorn possible and will certify and raise spirits of any gathering or festivity. Our current global climate crisis has malaffected many crops recently due to the extreme temperature changes in different regions of the Eastern Hemisphere. These intense weather conditions, in addition to animal competition for resources, have endangered the popcorn harvest and are predicted in the future to fall by 7 to 8% due to these complications. In general, the projected increases in temperatures, changes in precipitation patterns, drastic weather events, and violent winds may all result in reduced agricultural productivity in the future. Popcorn plants exhibit heliotropism, where they are dependent on the sun's heat to bloom and ripen, which is why scientists have been investigating the popcorn anatomy and physiology to find solutions to save the popcorn industry. Recently, a resolution had been simply to use a protective material such as a tarp or umbrella as a cover for the bushel. However, it's been discovered that this aesthetic wasn't desired for most farmers. Scientists have also resorted to harvesting it early in June and freezing it as a method of preservation, but it was found that the popcorn received frostbite and freezer burn as an unavoidable effect. A new variety has been bred that produces a hard crust exterior that protects it from the bitter weather and also happens to have a sweet outer layer that is edible and water resistant. As of late, many creatures of the wild, like ducks, have recognized and appreciated the popcorn plants nearly as much as we have, and seem to benefit from the food as well, due to its high quantity of nutrients, vitamins, and many forms of dietary fiber. However, ducks aren't the only ones in competition with popcorn consumption, because snack brands have begun challenging the popcorn culture with certain products within nut corporations and the pretzel enterprise in attempt to surface their manufacturing and product demand. But its actuality resulted in a newer creation of trail mix, which encompassed popcorn in combination with other snack companies. This overall expanded the use of popcorn and its popularity, which has led to recent increased profit and price. Descending into winter, popcorn continues to be a staple in holiday feasts and reunions, as well as decor piece in many households holding symbols of art expression and youth. As for the families in Vermont, a harvest of homegrown popcorn is a journey that has been and continues to be an unforgettable experience and extremely rewarding, although in many cultures, the process is not complete until nightfall, when your sofa awaits for company and the television begins a film, and all that is left is the presence of companionship and an abundant amount of popcorn.
Understand. Listen very closely if you possibly can. It's a story of two popcorn kernels in a red hot pan. One turned to the other and said, "Hey man, I'm too poop to pop, and I ain't lying. I'm too poop to pop, just laying here frying. Salt and butter's ready and the fire's hot, but seems like I'm just too poop to pop. Too poop to pop, and I ain't playing possum. I'm too poop to pop, and I do want to blossom. Don't like the bottom, want to get up on top. But seems like I'm just too poop to pop."